रहे।
when we are just saying that employee retention is a strategic approach, then that covers all three levels of the organization, at individual level, at the departmental level, and at the overall organizational level. Okay, I want to ask you one more question: whether employee retention is a HR process, that HR function, similar to your training and development or your performance management, or it is not? What is your opinion? It is a separate function, or it is a part of any other function?
तो इट इज लाइक वन ऑफ द कोर फंक्शन ऑफ एचआर एम्प्लॉय रिटेंशन।
Yeah, that I'm asking whether it is a core function or it is a part of any other core
नो
function.
नो इट्स अ कोर फंक्शन सर ऑफ द एचआर
Okay.
इज अ कोर फंक्शन द एचआर इज रिस्पांसिबल दैट द लाइक देयर एम्प्लॉयज डोंट लाइक टेंड टू बी There is an analysis which happens like once in a year at the end of the financial year. What was the percentage of like attrition which has happened? So retention happens to be play a very critical role.
Yeah, you, the same, whatever the answer that you are given, I want to ask the same question. Why it is happening at the every end of the year? Why it is not a continuous process? If it is a core function, then. As you said, it is a core function. Okay, that core function, that should be on regular basis rather than once in a year. Okay, after doing the analysis or at the time of exit interview of any employee, why it is happening at that moment only? Why it is not a continuous process? Why it is not a part of your talent management? Because talent management is a continuous process.
So I think because it only comes in the picture when somebody wants to leave the organization.
99% organizations, neglected this important core function of HR, that is employee retention. You are right. Okay, it is a core function, but the organization or the employed, they are not that much serious about the employee retention, because everyone's have a different perception. Some employer thinks that if the people stay in our organization, whatever their the cost to retain them in the organization, because as employee stay for a longer period, their salary also get increased. So the organization perception that we need to pay the more salary if that person stay in our organization for a more time. And another perception is that if the continuous people are changing, then we are getting a fresh blood, that is a new people coming in the organization. So the most of the organization think that we are getting a new insight, new growth approach. So these all are the illusions or the perception of most of the organization. Okay, if we are saying that employee is an asset, a human resource is an asset for the organization, then why the organization have the different perception? What do you think? Why such perception or such beliefs are there in most of the organization? Yes, quick one input.
So I didn't get your question.
My question is that every organization have the different belief about employee retention. Why people leave the organization? So some organization think that if the people are leaving, then it is good for the organization because they are getting the new employees in a less salary. Okay, some organization think that if the people are stay in the organization for a longer period, then whatever the cost for retaining them or staying in the organization is more than replacing them with the other employee. So why this such type of different perceptions every organization have?
So there are few organizations where who want the people to stay also, considering that flexibility and agility that they have, whereas most of the organizations happen to keep a change of employees in the organization to improve the culture. Like culturally, like even culture plays a very vital role at this role. So, culture reasons, then better prospects, they get a better growth opportunity wherein the current organization can't match up to the employee's expectations or standards. So there are certain these many times. So the employee potentially when the employer doesn't meets the purpose of retaining the employee.
Okay, we are talking in a two perception. One is employee perception, another one is employer perception. Now the discussion is going in the perception of employer. Why employer is not that much enthusiastic or passive optimistic about employee retention strategy?
So new people new ideas. New people bring new ideas.
Yes.
Yes. Change. Yes. As for the market trends. In terms of getting themselves adapted or bringing a change in terms of which would help or benefit the organization.
So whether employee retention means if the people leaving the organization, it is good for the organization or not in a current situation like we are in a VUCA world. The situation is a dynamic, it's not a static one, it's changing day by day, new technology is coming, new talent is required, it is not like that 30 years before one technology comes and stay for a 10 or 20 years time. Now if you see in last 2 years before, smart TVs are not there in the market in the sense it is there, but the popularity is not there or the cost is very high. But from last 2 years, if you see the smart TV, the normal LED TV will get replaced with a new smart TVs, and the cost is also for 9,000 and 10,000 rupees. You are getting the smart TV. So this is the new technologies coming, and it is at the very very cheap cost. It is very at the low cost. So if organization wants to survive in the VUCA world, what do you think whether the employee retention strategy is good for the organization, or if the organization not look that much seriously towards this strategy, it is okay? What is your opinion? Yes, my question is clear with you. So my question is, I want to know from you your side that employee retention, ठीक है, ये पहले 10 साल पहले अगर आप अगर आंसर देते कि employee retention is very important, दो perception है, दो coin के side है, one side is that talented employee you required to survive in the VUCA world, but those who are the underperformer, those who are not performing or those who are not talented, so what stand that you will take towards that employees, whether you'll put them in the performance development or that training development process, or whether you will fire them from the organization. So these are the two perceptions of the employee retention strategies. So what do you think, what is your opinion? I want to know.
So ideally, training of people is the solution on a long-term perspective. Firing them also creates a negative image of the organization. So organizations that take a step of fire and hire ideally lose the trust of their employees and also the image, because the exit employee happens to be your
ambassador.
Ambassador. So it does matter how the person has been exited. So I would say training and of course training also, if there are no you don't find any improvement, then it comes as a it's the last stage where we have to initiate the exit of that employee.
Okay. So let's start. We'll see. Meanwhile, in the lecture, all these points we are going to discuss with some questions also. So we can't stop employees from leaving unless we have a plan to make them stay. So this statement, says in relates with the two perceptions. That is employer perception also and employee perception also. No, any. If we are talking about employee perception, no one wants to stay for a longer time. Okay, because that is a human tendency that they don't want to stay for a longer time because they get bored or they are not getting a challenging task or career growth that we learn in career development. Okay, so a lot of the factors are responsible why employee is thinking to leave the organization. And retention strategy helps that organization how they can stop this brain drainage, or in short, when we are talking about talent management or the talented people, those who are leaving the organization. So we can't stop employees from leaving unless we have a plan to make them stay. That is nothing but employee retention strategy. So there are some few questions when we are talking about employee retention that comes in your mind, that it what is a relevant and voluntary turnover and what are related turnover cost. So there are two factors. Voluntarily, people are leaving the organization. Another side, the organization or the employer is retrenching or layoff or just firing the employee. Okay, due to some reason, there are a lot of internal factors also, external factors also. Due to COVID, that is an external factor. Most of the organization, they decrease their manpower in the in the industries or in the organization. So these are the external factors. Internal factors, if the underperformer employees or the project is going to close, okay, the organization don't require the skill set, the specific skill set, okay. So that's why the people are fired from the organization. So there are other legal things also. If the employees done some illegal things in the organization, they also get fired. So this is the relevant voluntary turnover, and when any human resource leaves the organization or the employee leaves the organization, there is a certain cost that needs to pay from both sides. Employee also pays pays in the, it is not in the monetary form, but something both the parties are losing. Okay, so what is that cost that we called as a turnover cost if the employees are leaving? Okay, so what is the turnover cost of that organization? That we need to think when we are discussing about retention strategy. Second one, how can the risk of voluntary turnover be estimated? Okay, that is possible nowadays with your analytics software or lots of applications are there. So with the help of predictive analysis, you can just find it out the risk of voluntary turnover. Okay. Third question is that how and why do employee leave voluntarily? Okay, if you are firing the employee, that is one case. But if the people are leaving the organization, so there is a major problem in your organization. Might be it is a cultural issue or it might be your process issue. Okay, so you need to find it out and you need to use appropriate interventions or develop OD interventions. Okay, if you not apply that interventions, then as I said, that the complete organization is depend upon the human resources that they are working in the organization. If you not focus on this issue, then that will impact overall organization performance. Next, what are the major component of retention strategy? That is also we are going to just check it out. What are the components? Okay, and finally, which measures helps to effectively retain talent? Finally, what that thing, okay, one that thing, okay, you can ask me, sir, what ये एक ऐसी चीज बताओ जो हमको रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी सक्सेसफुली हम इम्प्लीमेंट कर पाए या लोगों को बाहर जाने से रोक पाए. सो दैट व्हाट इज दैट थिंग दैट विल डिस्कस एट द एंड. सो दिस आर फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, ओके, अबाउट योर टर्नओवर, ओके, मैन पावर टर्नओवर. व्हाट आर द कॉमन व्यूज? परसेप्शन. So people who joins for money leaves for money. That is one perception of employer. Okay, every employer thinks that people join for a money and they leave for a money if they are not getting a proper remuneration or proper monetary benefits. Second common views, that is the people join companies and leave bosses. Okay, That happens if I'm joining any big company like TCS, Infosys, okay, due to the employer brand, I'm joining it, okay. But when I'm leaving the organization, I leave for a bad boss. Am I right? Please acknowledge me with for checking the connection.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So third one, you don't need to care about retention if you do well with all the rest. What the employer is thinking that if we focus on work-life balance things, if we compensate employee properly, okay, if we motivate employee through both rewards, that is extrinsic and intrinsic reward, then we don't need to think about the retention. People will, you know, stay in the organization. Okay, that is a common views. Okay, might be we can't say that this view is okay. Okay. Because finally, we cannot predict that why the employee will leave the organization. Okay, prediction is the sense up to some extent we can predict that this employee is in a red zone. Okay, in upcoming 3 years, this employee will leave our organization through some data analytics tools. But 100% we cannot sure it. Okay, so how you can complete? You cannot say that if you provide all the benefits. Okay. Then we don't need to take care of our retention strategy. That is also one common view. Fourth one, employees are free, which is fine. They can stay in the organization or they can leave the organization. Okay. So most of the organizations are very professional in nature. Okay. If the employees fire and hire strategy. Okay. If the employee is performing, they will keep you in the organization. Okay. And if the employee is not performing, they will fire you. The same perception is towards employee also. Employee, what employee says, the talented employee says that, okay, if the employer will provide me as per my work, then I will stay in the organization. If I feel, okay, that the employer is not paying well for me against my efforts, then I will leave the organization. Okay, so this is the two common views. Next, at the end of the day, retention is all about leadership. Okay, so as I told you, okay, in previous sessions also, there is a quite difference between manager and leadership. Managers are there for managing the resources. Managers are there, they are managing the resources with the help of the processes. Okay, but they are not a leader. Okay, every leader, okay, is a manager, but every manager is not a leader. Okay. So leader is something, okay, that they bind their followers with some a common belief, a common dream, a common objective. So if at the end of the day, retention is all about the leader, how the leadership, okay, plays an important role into your retention strategy, that is also important. If your manager is a good leader, then automatically, create some followers within your organization, and that followers will not leave the organization until and unless leaders, okay, allow him to, you know, leave the organization. That is a mutual relationship. Okay, both way, they are mutually bound. They are emotionally bound with each other because the followers are emotionally bound with their leaders, but they are not bound with the managers. That is the difference. Next. Losing an employee leads to cost 1 to 2 times of his or her annual salary. Okay, so if any employees are leaving the organization, okay, it is a 1 to 2 times of his annual salary. So that is a huge turnover cost. Okay, employee, it says that if you keep your if employees stay in the organization, that cost is, you know, much lesser than if employee leave the organization and if we are replacing that employee with another employee. Okay, that cost is a bigger than, okay, the employee if stay in the organization. So we need to think about retention strategy very seriously when we look towards organizational performance, or if you want effective talent management strategy within the organization. So finally, talent management strategy directly related to your retention strategy. If your retention strategy is not properly, or it is effective, then your talent management strategy is completely fails, okay, in the organization. So retention, if you cannot stop your talented employees, how you are going to manage the talented employees within the organization? To whom will you manage? That is a big question. Next, the strongest are the first to leave the company. That is the big perception. Okay, yes, it is true some up to some extent that those who are the talented, those who are the strongest, those have the high competencies, okay, that they are having ample of opportunity in the market, business environment. Okay, they get the opportunity. If you are not providing them a proper a pay, a proper extrinsic and intrinsic things, benefits, then they will leave the organization. Okay, happy employees prefers to stay. Yes, that is also true, because if you are happy, what is the definition of happy? That depends upon everyone's, you know, that is an individual perception. Everyone's have the different definition about the happiness. Okay. And if you're happy, always you love to, you know, love to stay with that particular thing, whether it is a tangible or intangible. Okay. If you like your, if you happy to purchase an Apple phone, purchase it. Okay. So happy is the some word that intrinsically, okay, link with your soul. Okay. So if your soul is happy, automatically you'll always stay with that thing. And at last, to a certain extent, turnover is good. That I have asked you the question at the starting of our lecture, whether turnover is good or bad for the organization. So that question's answer will be some sort of diplomatic answer. Like if you are focusing on the talented employees, okay, then turnover is not good. Okay. So there, the retention strategy is very important. And if you are talking about underperformer or such kinds of employees, okay, that they are not able to upgrade their performance after giving some, various chance, okay, to those employees, then turnover is good, because always it is better that if you are replacing the underperformer with the performers, okay, the smart employees, okay. So if you say the retention strategy linked with your recruitment and selection also, that is the talent acquisition. Your retention strategy is linked with your training and development also. Retention strategy is linked with your performance management also. Retention strategy is linked with your compensation and benefit also. Okay. So all these HR functions are directly linked with your retention. When you are talking about talent management, then retention and talent is two sides of the coins. Okay, talent management will be an effective tool when we have the effective retention strategy. Guys, are you getting clear? Is there any question?
No, sir.
No. Right. Yeah. So what is the introduction? The challenge is not only to attract the best talent, but also to retain them. Okay, so you can attract the people, but how you can retain them? And retention strategy starts from onboarding itself. When the people or when the employee join your organization, and from the first day retention strategy gets started, it gets end in exit interview. Okay, तो ये जो गैप है बड़ा, ठीक है, ऑनबोर्डिंग रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी चालू हो जाता है और एग्जिट इंटरव्यू में वो एंड हो जाता है. तो ये जो बीच का गैप है ना, दैट इज योर नथिंग बट योर इफेक्टिव रिटेंशन, हाउ यू आर रिटेनिंग द एम्प्लॉइज. सो फिर विद वेरियस प्रोसेस लाइक परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट, कॉम्पनसेशन एंड बेनिफिट, ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट, करियर डेवलपमेंट, ऑल दीज आर द रिलेटेड प्रोसेस. ओके, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस प्रोसेस यू आर रिटेनिंग द एम्प्लॉइज. ओके, राइजिंग opportunity for career development, lifestyle decision, job changing, unbalanced work life, these are the major challenges which influence an individual decision to continue or quit. Okay, so no one wants to quit the job until and unless he gets the good opportunity in the market. Okay, aisa koi employee ya candidate nahi hoga jo chalo aaj chhodna hai mujhe, resign karna hai, to aise kar diya resign, aise nahi hoga. Because finally, everyone's basic need is money. Basic, I'm saying. Once you financially stable, then the other needs comes. Okay, that is the Maslow hierarchy theory that you learn in organizational behavior, or that is a effective motivational theory. Once your basic needs get fulfilled, then you think about the next need. Okay. So employee retention is a process in which the employees are encouraged to remain with the organization for the maximum period of time or until the completion of the project. Here, the important keyword is encourage and maximum period. These two keywords are very important. This one, encourage. How you are going to encourage the employees to remain with the organization? But with remain with the organization for what? For maximum period of time. Until one project or one assignment or whatever the, you know, the requirement of the organization. So it's a professional relationship. It is not like that. The organization ka requirement nahi hai, fir bhi aapko rakha hai organization. Okay, it happens only in government sector. Okay, so it because every organization is professional in nature. Okay, and they think for their long term goals. Okay, if you fit for that long term goals, then you can, you know, stay with that organization for a longer period. If you suits for that organization for a short-term goal, then your, you know, the span of working is very short in that organization. So that is a part of your retention strategy. For how much time you require that person, okay, that is also one, you know, part of that, for one step of that retention strategy that you need to think. You cannot say that every 100 employees is there working with me, I require all 100 employees with me for upcoming 10 years. Okay. You cannot say it because in a recent, you know, in a current situation, okay, every organization have a very different challenges. A dynamic environment, VUCA environment affecting overall process of the organization. I'm talking about employer perception. When we come towards the employee perception towards, you know, to stay in the organization or not, that is some different questions and answers. But when we talk about the employer perception, organization needs to define a strategy at individual level. Okay. And that individual strategy, retention strategy, should link with the departmental level, and then it should be overall organization level. When we say overall organization level, then I'm saying up for a longer time. Okay, for a long-term basis. When we say about that departmental level or for that project specific level, then that is nothing but a short term. 1 year or 2 year or max 3 years span. Once that task is accomplished or that project gets end, your requirement get finished. And accordingly, you need to, you know, link this retention strategy with your recruitment and selection. Okay, how we are, you know, because you must know that ye maine 100 mein se 10 employees ko short term isme rakha hai, span mein rakha hai. To aane wale 2 saal mein ye 10 vacancies hone wale hain. What type of skill set are required? Okay, that should be defined by your talent management expert. Okay, and based on the talent management analysis, then you give that specific requirement to your recruitment and selection section. The recruiters and recruitment and selection department will then, you know, search for that specific skills talent, and then they will hire for your organization. This is nothing but the flexible employee retention strategy. Yes. Is there any doubt in this? Till now you are getting, Sunny? Alicia, Vincia?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you want to put any sorts of, you know, your opinion points, you can put it. Yes. Employee retention will benefit an organization. Okay. So in which way the employee retention will benefit organization? The cost of turnover. If the employees are not leaving the organization, in a general way, I'm saying, not in a specific way. Okay. In a general way, I'm saying that if the employees are not leaving, then your cost of turnover is less. Loss of company knowledge, that is brain drain, will not happen. Okay. Your talented employees will not leave the organization. Interruption of customer service. Okay. So succession planning, as I said, now succession planning is not for the top level management also, but it thorough from top to bottom level. Okay. When if any employee is leaving the organization, its successor should be ready for replacing that employee. Okay. So it's avoid in interruption of any customer service or the process of the organization. Next is turnover leads to more turnovers. Okay. What this terms indicates? Turnover leads to more turnovers. If my friend leaves the organization because he was insulted by the manager, manager insulted him, okay, and torturing, exploiting him, okay, and he leaves that organization, then directly it's impacting on my perception also. My point of view is going to change towards the organization. मैं सोचूंगा यार मेरे दोस्त के साथ ऐसे हुआ है तो मेरे साथ ये क्यों नहीं करेंगे. नाउ दे रिक्वायर्ड मी, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर नॉट डूइंग द सेम थिंग दैट दे डन विद माय फ्रेंड. ओके, बट वंस द रिक्वायरमेंट गेट फिनिश्ड देन दे विल डू द सेम थिंग विद मी. सो इट्स बेटर टू लीव दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. दैट इज नथिंग बट टर्न ओवर लेट्स टू मोर टर्न ओवर्स. एक ने अगर कंपनी छोड़ दी तो दूसरे भी कंपनी छोड़ देंगे. ओके, सो दैट इज अ बैड इमेज इज क्रिएटेड. ओके, एम्प्लॉयर ब्रांड इज created amongst your employee. Goodwill of the company, okay, that is also one benefit, and regaining efficiency. Okay, if retention strategy is good, then your organization is more efficient. They will the employees are more efficient. So that is some benefit that the employees are getting. So what are the five major things involved in retention? First one is compensation. So you retain your employees through paying a well compensation. Second one is your organization culture, that is environment. Third one is your career development. Okay, that is growth within the organization, or if you are giving an opportunity to self development. Okay. Next is relationship. So how your peer ones, your colleagues, your boss, जितने भी आपके आजू बाजू लोग हैं उनके साथ आपका रिलेशनशिप कैसा है. इफ योर बॉस, मैं अगर क्वेश्चन पूछूंगा कि आपका बॉस कैसा है, व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन अबाउट योर बॉस. ठीक है, तो 90% 80% लोगों का, 90-80% लोगों का यही कहना आएगा, नहीं माय बॉस इज नॉट गुड. ओके, यही इंडियन इंडियन कल्चर इंडियन सिनारियो में मैं बोल रहा हूँ. 80% एम्प्लॉयज विल से दैट माय बॉस इज नॉट गुड. So what factor? That is a relationship. How you are maintaining an effective relationship with your peer ones, your superior ones. And finally, the support. Support is in the form of work-life balance. If any employee is struggling with the health issues, okay, and he wants work from home option for some specific days. And if you are not supporting that employee and saying that no, you must come to organization, you must need to come to the organization to work, that is your personal issue, health is your personal issue, you cannot supporting the employee, so the it impact your retention. So these are the few five factors. इससे भी ज्यादा हो सकते हैं, but five factors है. Compensation, monetary and non-monetary, environment, that is culture, growth, that is your individual growth, company growth, and employee growth also, then relationship, and finally the support. So these five elements involves in retention. So you know that we in last lecture we have learned that is what the compensation means and what reward means. Compensation include your salary, wages, bonus, health insurance, and some after retirement benefit plan. So most of the organization in the current situation, what are the challenges that the organizations are facing? Okay, the challenges I can divide in two ways, internal and external. Okay, worker shortage is an external challenge. Skill shortage is an external challenge. Talent management is an internal challenge. How your organization policy is effective in managing the talent. Generational difference. Different age group people are working in your organization. What are the relationships amongst them? ऐसा भी होता है कि 30 to 50 years range के employees होते हैं, that is class 3 clerical employees or admin staff, और उनके ऊपर अगर कम एज का या 25 या 27 years का manager MBA वाला आपने लाके उनके सिर के ऊपर बिठाया है, तो that is a generational gap. तो एक ईगो क्लैशेस हो जाता है कि मैं यहाँ पे 15 साल से काम कर रहा हूँ, मेरा एज इतना है, और मुझे लीड कौन कर रहा है, तो अभी अभी जो पास आउट हुआ है या अभी अभी जो जिसका एज है ना लेस देन अस है, कम है हमारे हमारे से, ठीक है, वो हमको लीड कर रहा है. सो दैट इज द ईगो प्रॉब्लम कम्स, दैट इज द जनरेशन गैप्स, एंड इट इज अ मेजर इश्यूज. मिलेनियल्स है, एक्स जनरेशन है, वाई जनरेशन है, how the people with the different generations, okay, they are behaving with each other, that is the major issue. Global competition, yes. जो आप 5 साल पहले जितने भी companies देखते होंगे वो अभी exist नहीं करते, majority I am saying, नॉट अ बिग कंपनीज लाइक गूगल या फेसबुक ओके, बट जितने भी अगर आप कंपनीज देखेंगे जो ओपन हुए थे, हाँ, जैसे आप मोबाइल फोन का कंपनीज ले लीजिए, माइक्रोमैक्स आपको नहीं दिखेगा, ठीक है, फिर आपका लावा जो मोबाइल फोन है इंडियन वो नहीं दिखेगा, हाँ? आने वाले दिनों में 5 साल बाद आप शाओमी या रेडमी या जो बाकी के कंपनीज है वो देख पाएंगे या नहीं देख पाएंगे, दैट इज अ बिग क्वेश्चन ओके, बिकॉज ग्लोबल सिनेरियो, ग्लोबल कॉम्पिटिशन दैट इज कम्प्लीटली चेंजिंग. एंड अनदर वन, जैसे हम बोलते हैं ना एक कैटलिस्ट होता है, केमिस्ट्री में कैटलिस्ट का मीनिंग क्या होता है कि ये स्टिमुलस देता है, कोई भी केमिकल रिएक्शन हो रहा है तो उसको स्टिमुलाई करता है, उसको बढ़ाता है ओके. सो कोविड फैक्टर इज अ कैटलिस्ट इन द दिस चेंजिंग एनवायरमेंट. कोविड फैक्टर क्या हुआ है, कोविड फैक्टर ने एक स्टिमुलस दिया, एक यू नो एक फास्ट उसको कर दिया है चेंज जो होने वाला था, जो 10 साल बाद चेंज होने वाला था या 5 साल बाद जो चेंज होने वाला था वो अभी ये 2 साल में आप देखेंगे. सो दैट इज द इंक्रीजिंग कॉम्पिटिशन, इंक्रीजिंग चेंजिंग द बिजनेस सिनेरियो, डाइवर्सिटी एज आई सेड, जेंडर डाइवर्सनेस, एज ग्रुप डाइवर्सनेस, जनरेशनल गैप ओके, ऑल दिस कम्स अंडर द डाइवर्सिटी एंड द लॉयलिटी. This is the individual perception, okay, how the individual employee is looking towards their organization. It's a loyalty is very important factor nowadays. If loyalty is there, then only, you know, you can believe on your employees. If the loyalty is not, then how you can believe? Because loyalty is the main factor of motivation. Ki aap kaam kaise karte, aapka perception kya, positive attitude hai ka negative attitude hai. Okay, that is very important. So this is all about the challenges facing by the organization. Next, critical findings. One of every three people plan on living in the next 2 years. Aap char log ho. How many of you think that in upcoming 2 years you are thinking to leave the organization? Yes. It is confidential. Class ke baar nahi jayega. Yes.
Sir, I'm actually thinking not after 2 years, before 2 years itself.
Yeah, you're thinking. Yeah? Yes?
Yes.
Yeah. So this statement is very true. That is, critical finding is that one out of every three people plan on living in the next 2 years. So that is a big challenge then for the organization. How they can retain you. Okay. If they think that you're suited for their long-term goal. और ये वैसा वर्षा भी है, एम्प्लॉय को भी सोचना है कि कितने साल तक मुझे इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ रहना है. आप ये नहीं सोच सकते कि यार मैंने एक बार ज्वाइन कर दिया ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तो चलो रिटायर्ड होंगे इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से, इट कैन नॉट प्रेडिक्ट. अगर आप नहीं सोचोगे ऐसा तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने सोच के ही आपको हायर किया है कि आप 2 साल या 5 साल ही आपको रहना है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में, आप ये मत सोचिए, ठीक है. सो बिकॉज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी कुछ नहीं कर सकता, चेंजिंग बिजनेस रिक्वायरमेंट इज टोटली डिफरेंट ओके. आप 5 साल अभी आपको पर्टिकुलर स्किल सेट के लिए आपको हायर किया है, 5 साल बाद नया स्किल सेट आ जाएगा. अगर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सोचता है कि आई डोंट वांट टू स्पेंड मनी इन ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट और डेवलपिंग माय एक्जिस्टिंग एम्प्लॉय, इफ दे आर गेटिंग अ वेरी यू नो टैलेंटेड एम्प्लॉय इन अ लेस कॉस्ट आफ्टर 5 years, दे विल रिप्लेस यू ओके. सो दिस इज अ न्यू डायमेंशंस आर कमिंग इन द बिजनेसेस. So you need to be very ready with your career development, how you can, you know, upgrade yourself on a continuous basis. Okay. So ye question nahi aana chahiye ki agar organization aapse poochta hai ki abhi naya technology aaya hai, whether you are comfortable with this new technology or not. At that time, you cannot say that, please give me the training. Yeah. You need to be ready. Okay. With the upcoming technology. Okay. Nahi to aapko job chhodna padega. Okay. Cost much more to replace employees than to keep them. Okay, so that is very important, how they can make a balance in between. I'm not saying that retention is good or bad. I'm saying that how you can look towards that retention strategy. If you are looking for a talented employees, then that is a good strategy, a good approach. When you are looking for underperformer or the employees are not, you know, adding any value to your organizational growth, then retention strategy is bad. You cannot apply a retention strategy to those employees. if consistently if they are not applying, you know, if they are not adding value to your organizational performance, then you need to, you know, take a strict decision. Okay, this is about your employer perception. When we talk about the employee perception, if you are underperformer and if you want to continue with that organization, if you see that lots of opportunities are there in this organization, then you need to upgrade. You need to plan about your career, how you can upgrade, how you can meet the requirement of your organization. That is important if you are to stay in that organization. And in that, the retention strategy will help you. They will provide you training and development, okay, opportunity. They will help you if you are having a huge skill gap, okay. So that should be an effective communication. Communication plays an important role in both things. Every process in the organization requires a proper communication channel. If there is a lax in the communication, then you know what happens, okay. Communication is an important one, okay. So, कोई भी चीज आपको इफेक्टिवली अगर करना है तो आपको कम्युनिकेट करना आना चाहिए एंड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन पॉलिसी शुड यू नो हेल्प्स यू ओके एंड क्रिएट दैट एनवायरमेंट दैट यू कैन डायरेक्टली टॉक विद योर मैनेजर और योर टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम विद यू. ऐसा नहीं है कि टू वे से कम्युनिकेशन का टू वे से टोटली स्टॉप हो चुका है एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट ओके. So, दोनों तरफ से भी प्रॉब्लम आ जाएंगे. एम्प्लॉय विल डोंट नो वेयर ही इज लूजिंग एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑल्सो डोंट नो हाउ दे कैन इम्प्रूव दैट एम्प्लॉय. सो इफ यू सी द टाइप्स ऑफ टर्नओवर्स, टर्नओवर फर्स्ट द प्रोसेस इन विच एम्प्लॉय लीव ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड हाउ टू बी रिप्लेस. दिस इज टर्नओवर, द सिंपलेस्ट. इनवॉलंटरी टर्नओवर, turnover initiated by the organization often amongst a people who would prefer to stay. Okay, so ye involuntary turnover hai, aapko rehna hai us organization mein but due to some reason you need to leave that organization. Okay, so covid situation mein involuntary turnover bahut sare hue ya during recession period, ye cheeze bahut sari ye bahut baar dekhi jati hai. Voluntary turnover is nothing but turnover initiated by the employees against the wish of the company. Okay, if employer wants you but due to the high demand in the market, okay, for your skills, and if there are other organizations are paying a good pay for you, then you choose for this option, and that is called as a voluntary turnover. And early turnover is nothing but you join the organization, okay, and within 1 week or within 2 months time during probation, okay, you are leaving the organization. Okay, that is called as an early turnover. So how the turnover rate is calculated? Number of employees leaving the company in the year and the number of employees at the mid-year into 100%. So this is a formula in which you can just put a figures and calculate it. Whatever the figure is coming out, that is your turnover rate of that organization. Okay, so if you want to understand what are the types of turnover, involuntary, voluntary, and early turnover. These are the four categories. And how to calculate turnover rate? Number of employees leaving the company in the year divided by number of employees at the mid-year and into 100%. Okay, so turnover performance relation, how you can relate a performance with your turnover. Okay, if your employees are performing low, then your turnover rate is high. If your employees is performing high, then also your turnover rate is high. So the average performers, okay, will stay in your organization for a longer period. This is the block. The average performer will stay in your organization for a longer period. If they are the underperformer, the involuntary turnover rate is high. And in a high performance this zone, the voluntary turnover is high. Are you getting it? Yes, समझ में आ रहा है ये चार्ट? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Here the involuntary turnover is high, and here the voluntary turnover is high, and here your turnover is very low because here the average performer will not leave the organization. ओके और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी क्या सोचेगा, चलो एवरेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस है, जब तक उनका रिक्वायरमेंट है दे विल प्लेस, ओके कभी ना कभी ये इस जोन में आ जाएंगे और या इस जोन में आ जाएंगे, देन दे विल ऑटोमेटिकली लीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। तो आपको किन लोगों के ऊपर ध्यान देना है ज्यादा, हियर द रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी इज वेरी इफेक्टिव, ओके दिस इज गुड फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, हियर द रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी इज बैड फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। ओके यू नीड डोंट नीड टू थिंक अबाउट दिस लो परफॉर्मर, ओके इफ दे आर लिविंग द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन देन इट इज ओके, ओके and but there are two you know question the one question is coming na that whether retention is good or bad for the organization. Here this chart gives you the clear understanding that if this performance is high, here the retention strategy is mandatory or required, here if it is not then it is okay. Okay, yes, this chart gives you a more understanding. If you see here, these are the four quadrants. Here non-key functions are there, that is critical roles and non-critical role. Lots of time we discuss this. Critical role for every organization is different, okay, as per the requirement and as per their business environment. Okay, so key function is the critical role. Non-key function is nothing but your day-to-day process. Okay, कोई अगर employee छोड़ के भी चला जाता है तो यू कैन रिप्लेस इजीली और मार्केट में वर्कफोर्स अवेलेबल है उसके लिए, ठीक है, तो यू कैन रिप्लेस इट। की फंक्शन इज सम टाइप टेक्निकल पीपल और द साइंटिस्ट रिसर्चर या कोई इंजीनियर्स, द टेक्निकल पीपल्स यू कैन नॉट रिप्लेस देम विथ एनी अदर पीपल, ओके या उसको बहुत टाइम लगने वाला है रिप्लेसमेंट के लिए, सो दिस आर द की फंक्शंस। ओके यहाँ पे है आपका अदर्स एंड हाई परफॉर्मर्स and high potential. Non-key functions, okay, high performer, इसमें कुछ important नहीं है, but हमको कहाँ पे देखना है, key function over high performer. यहाँ पे retention strategy plays an important role. यहाँ पे अगर turnover rate ज्यादा है इस block में, जहाँ पे key function है and high performer लोग हैं, ठीक है, अगर ये छोड़ के जा रहे हैं organization को, यहाँ पे turnover ज्यादा है, तो that is very important. You need to take care of it. And retention strategy plays an important role here. Yes, got it? Please acknowledge.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So turnover cost, there are direct and indirect cost. Okay, direct cost, you know, if any employee leaves the organization, then separation cost, vacancy, फिर उसका marketing किया जाएगा, that is nothing but you put a ad, okay, then recruitment and selection process, onboarding, training the employee and then they join the organization in a full flesh. So this is the direct cost, okay. So in this process, lots of money you spend on the employees, okay. But what are the indirect cost? Okay, lost productivity of incumbent, जो vacant हो रहा है position, उसका प्रोडक्टिविटी स्टॉप हो जाएगा, लॉस प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ अदर एम्प्लॉइज। जैसे मैंने कहा कि अगर आपके ग्रुप में का दो एम्प्लॉय छोड़ के चले जाते हैं, देन अदर एम्प्लॉइज के ऊपर उसका डायरेक्ट इंपैक्ट होगा, दे आल्सो फील अनसिक्योर्ड, ओके एंड दे विल आल्सो स्टार्ट सर्चिंग अ न्यू अपॉर्चुनिटीज, सो दैट विल इंपैक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ब्रांड। लॉस प्रोडक्टिविटी वैकेंट पोजिशन, लॉस प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ अदर एम्प्लॉइज, लर्निंग कर्व ऑफ न्यू हायर, ओके दैट इज ऑल्सो how the new joinee, okay, during the onboarding, what are the, you know, the skills or capabilities, whether he that new joinee is a quick learner or it's required some time, that also a matter that comes under indirect cost, and training, loss productivity of other employees. Okay, so these are some indirect cost. Ye most of the organization dhyan nahi dete, they know about this, they have the ready made estimate. अगर 10 एम्प्लॉयज वो निकाल दे रहे तो उनके पास प्रॉपर पेपर वर्क होता है कि कितना उनको कॉस्ट होने वाला है न्यू एम्प्लॉयज रिप्लेस करने के लिए, बट ये जो हिडन कॉस्ट है ये इसको और बढ़ा देते हैं, ओके सो यू नीड टू थिंक अबाउट इट। सो दिस इज द हिडन कॉस्ट, दिस इज द डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, प्री डिपार्चर, वैकेंसी एंड इंट्रोडक्शन, दैट इज एम्प्लॉय लीव्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, न्यू एम्प्लॉयज इज हायर्ड एंड न्यू एम्प्लॉय फुल्ली इफेक्टिव। सो दिस इज द फ्लो चार्ट, समझ में आ रहा है आपको ये चार्ट? किसी पॉइंट पे प्रॉब्लम है क्या यहाँ पे समझने के लिए? इट्स वेरी इजी. दिस इज द डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, दिस इज द इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, एंड दिस इज द फ्लो. दिस इज द फर्स्ट.
सो दिस कैन बी ए मैनेज्ड बाय नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, राइट? द हिडन कॉस्ट, द नॉलेज व्हिच
इज. नो नो, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रिटेंशन वन. सो व्हाट इज द टर्नओवर कॉस्ट? अगर कोई एम्प्लॉय छोड़ के जा रहा है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सो व्हाट how much it you know that company needs to you know pay for against that employee or against that vacancy till the other people other employee join that. देखिए ना, अगर आप देख रहे हो कोई भी और कोई भी पोजिशन वैकेंट हो रही है तो वो फिल अप होने तक, क्योंकि फिल अप होने के लिए क्या करना पड़ेगा? अगर फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप आपका
visible part I got visible part but point is about hidden cost. So here you one point is mentioned lost productivity.
फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर द एक्सपीरियंस एम्प्लॉय इन योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ओके? सो वेन यू लीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन यू आर गोइंग विद योर टैसिट नॉलेज.
सो दिस इज
योर एक्सपीरियंस. यस, नॉलेज. यस, नॉलेज, नॉलेज. So if any new employee is replacing you, he's you can train him with the knowledge. Okay, it is not a knowledge. You can train him through a knowledge. But what about experience? What about that tacit knowledge? Because tacit knowledge, that cannot be shared, na? That resides in everyone's brain. Okay. So positive attitude is a part. Experience, how you can handle, you know. देखिए, मैंने सबसे बेस्ट एग्जांपल में जब भी नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट सिखाता हूँ बच्चों को देता हूँ कि अगर चाय बनाने का, अगर देखिए आपके घर में 5 लोग हैं और उनको कहा जाए आप चाय बनाओ तो हर एक का टेस्ट अलग अलग आएगा. प्रोसेस सेम है. आपको एक टीस्पून ही चाय पत्ती डालना है, शक्कर 2 टीस्पून डालना है, मिल्क प्रॉपर क्वांटिटी में, सबको एक मेजरमेंट दे दिया है, बट हर एक का टेस्ट अलग आएगा. ये क्यों आता है? Those they have the proper. तो इसलिए process doesn't matter. Process कितना भी आपका strong हो, but employee matters. That's why we said ना, that is employee is a important asset for the organization. Everyone attitude is different. Everyone working style is different. Okay. So that's why if anyone leaves the organization, lost productivity of vacant position. आप ऐसे नहीं बोलोगे पुराना वाला employee उल्टा भी हो सकता है. ठीक है, दैट इज वी आर थिंकिंग इन अ नेगेटिव वे. दैट इज अगर नया एम्प्लॉई ठीक है उतना इफिशियंट नहीं होगा तो देन वी लॉस दिस प्रोडक्टिविटी. यस, इट इज रिलेटेड टू योर नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट एज यू सेड. ओके,
यस.
नेक्स्ट, टर्नओवर कॉस्ट. सो वी आर कंपेयरिंग टर्नओवर कॉस्ट विद डिफरेंट लेवल्स, डिफरेंट डेजिग्नेशंस. इफ यू सी एंट्री लेवल, turnover cost is very less. If employee join organization and within you know, short time, 1 or 2 month time, whether if that employee leaves, then turnover cost is very less. If we check this, specialist people, key role people, or engineers, okay, or the technical people, their turnover cost is very high. Specialist is nothing but your researchers, the key positions for your organization, okay. तो आपका अगर बैंकिंग फर्म है तो आपका CFO इज अ स्पेशलिस्ट पर्सन. जो फंड मैनेजर होता है, फंड मैनेज करता है, सारे स्टफ फाइनेंशियल देखता है, सो दैट इज द स्पेशलिस्ट पर्सन. इफ ही लीव्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन देन टर्नओवर कॉस्ट इज वेरी हाई. अ टॉप लेवल लीडर्स, अ प्रोसेस ओनर्स. ओके, तो एज द रोल गेट चेंज योर टर्नओवर कॉस्ट विल गेट चेंज. दिस चार्ट सेज अबाउट अ डिफरेंट. देखिए, स्किल्ड अवर्स, क्लेरिकल एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव, ठीक है, आपको वर्क लेबर मार्केट में बहुत सारे क्लेरिकल लोग मिल जाएंगे. सो देयर टर्न ओवर कॉस्ट इज वेरी लेस. ओके, यू नीड्स टू प्रोवाइड देम ओनली द ट्रेनिंग और यू नीड टू गिव द प्रोसेस नॉलेज वेन दे ज्वाइन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट्स इट. यहाँ पे टैसिट नॉलेज का इतना इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं है बिकॉज ऑल दिस प्रोसेस आर द रिपीटेटिव प्रोसेस. एक्सप्लिसिट एंड टैसिट नॉलेज में डिफरेंस आता है यहाँ पे. Because specialist people, engineers, your technical, all these have has the tacit knowledge. When they leave the organization, they will take that knowledge with them. Okay, so it's very difficult, okay, to replace them for a future. So that's why the turnover cost is very more. And other people's, their turnover cost is less. Okay, because the tacit knowledge, their importance of tacit knowledge is not that much in their day-to-day work. They are handling the process, they are handling the system as it is. जैसे एक बैंक में अकाउंटेंट होता है, उसका कैशियर होता है, उसका काम ही होता है कि कैश डिपॉजिट करना और डिस्पैच करना, एक ही काम है. अगर वो छोड़ के जाता है तो उसकी जगह कोई भी रिप्लेस हो सकता है. उसको सिर्फ बताना कि आप कैश कैसे डिपॉजिट करके लोगे और दोगे कैसे, ठीक है. बट आप मुझे सोचिए, अगर एक बैंक का मैनेजर ही निकल जाएगा जो डेली के सारे टास्क दिखता था, प्रॉपरली स्ट्रीमलाइन करके प्रोसेस हैंडल करता था, इफेक्टिवली करता था, ठीक है. अगर वो निकल जाएगा तो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, न्यू जो मैनेजर आएगा उसको अंडरस्टैंड करने में सारे प्रोसेसेस, वर्क कल्चर, सारे एम्प्लॉयज के जनरेशन गैप्स, डाइवर्सिटी, ये सारी चीजें ये करने में दिक्कत होगी, ठीक है. जैसे पहले का मैनेजर जो ओल्ड एज एम्प्लॉयज है उनके ब्रांच में, उनको ज्यादा फेवर करता था, ठीक है, थोड़ा वो देर से आते हैं या स्लो काम करते हैं तो उनको मोटिवेट करता था. बट जो न्यू मैनेजर आएगा वो सेम चीजें करेगा, इट्स नॉट मैंडेटरी. ओके, सो पर्सन टू पर्सन इट गेट चेंज. आर यू गेटिंग इट? टर्न ओवर कॉस्ट, हाउ इट्स रिलेटेड विथ योर डिफरेंट डेजिग्नेशन. यहाँ पे हमने देखा था परफॉर्मेंस रिलेटेड, ठीक है. यहाँ पे हमने टर्नओवर कॉस्ट को कंपेयर किया था परफॉर्मेंस रिलेटेड, यस, यहाँ पे इस स्लाइड में. और यहाँ पे हमने कंपेयर किया है विद द डिफरेंट डेजिग्नेशन. यस गाइस, गॉट इट? क्विकली रिप्लाई. एम ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यस सर, यस सर.
इंडिविजुअल इंडिकेटर्स, सो वॉट आर द सिम्टम्स? कोई भी बीमारी होने से पहले, कोई भी डिसीज होने से पहले आपको सिम्टम्स आते हैं. तो कोई भी अगर एम्प्लॉई छोड़ के जा रहा है आपका ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, तो वॉट आर द सिम्टम्स, वॉट आर द इंटेंशंस? सडन परफॉर्मेंस ड्रॉप, फ्रिक्वेंट शॉर्ट टर्म एब्सेंस, रिड्यूस सोशल इंटरेक्शन एंड आइसोलेशन, ग्रुप के साथ ज्यादा बात नहीं करेगा जो ग्रुप में टीम मेंबर्स है, मैनेजर के साथ बात नहीं करेगा ज्यादा, जितना काम दिया जाए उतना ही करेगा, फ्रिक्वेंट कंप्लेन्स, ग्लोरीफाई अदर कंपनीज, रिड्यूस विलिंगनेस टू टेक ओवर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, ठीक है, पेसिमिज्म अबाउट फ्यूचर पर्सपेक्टिव. सो ऑल दिस आर द सिम्टम्स दैट एम्प्लॉयज आर लिविंग, मीन्स इंटेंट टू लीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो हियर मैनेजर नीड्स टू थिंक अबाउट इट. कोई भी ऐसे सिम्टम्स अगर आपको दिखते हैं बींग एन मैनेजर, यू नीड टू क्विकली अप्लाई द रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी. रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी इज अ फ्रिक्वेंसी, इट इज अ कंटिन्यूअस वन, बट आपको फिर स्पेसिफिकली देखना पड़ेगा, काउंसलिंग करना पड़ेगा, मीटिंग करना पड़ेगा. इफ इफ दैट एम्प्लॉय इज कम अंडर दैट लॉन्ग टर्म वाला जोन, ठीक है. अगर शॉर्ट टर्म में है, अगर एंड होने वाला है प्रोजेक्ट, एंड इफ यू वांट टू लीव देन यू कैन अलाउ हिम. टॉप मैनेजमेंट व्यू ऑन रिटेंशन, लैक विल गो फ्रॉम बॉटम टू टॉप. लैक ऑफ ट्रेनिंग, टॉप मैनेजमेंट थिंक दैट हाउ द रिटेंशन means people leaving the organization, okay, and how the retention strategy is effective. Lack of training is one reason. Image problem of the industry and the company. Benefit to do not compare favorably with industry peers. Aapka ek friend dusre company mein kaam kar raha hai, for example aap pharma company mein kaam kar rahe ho, same designation pe, aur aapka dost bhi dusre company mein same designation pe hai, but there is a big difference between your salary, okay. So that makes you know to leave the organization. Lack of leadership support from the senior manager. Senior manager always trying to showcase his performance only rather than his subordinate performance. Sorry. Lack of challenging, exciting task. Some people are getting a repetitive work. Okay. So they are not satisfied. They are satisfied with the benefits, compensation benefit, but they are not satisfied with the challenging task. ओके, तो यहाँ पे इंडिविजुअल पर्सनैलिटी का भी रोल इंपॉर्टेंट है व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटेजी इन एम्प्लॉय पर्सपेक्टिव. सो एवरी इंडिविजुअल इज डिफरेंट इन नेचर, एवरी एम्प्लॉयज टेस्ट इज डिफरेंट. किसी को पैसा अच्छा लगेगा, पैसा तो बेसिक नीड है, मनी इज अ बेसिक नीड, बट सम पीपल लाइक्स अ चैलेंजिंग टास्क, दे आर मोर वर्क फ्रेंडली, दे वॉन्ट टू डू द वर्क, दे वॉन्ट टू प्रूव देमसेल्फ. They are very habitual to take the challenges and succeed it. Okay. So, agar aap unko kam bhi paisa doge to bhi chalega, but they want a challenging task. So, that is the manager responsibility to identify, group their employees, okay, within a different category and then just try to just think how the retention strategy he can apply on those employees. ओके ये मैनेजर यहाँ पे मैनेजर का रोल इतना इंपॉर्टेंट है. एचआर का रोल तो बाद में आएगा ठीक है. एचआर पीपल आर देयर बट द मैनेजर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मैनेजर नीड्स टू थिंक अबाउट देयर सबॉर्डिनेट्स. दे नीड्स टू फाइंड इट आउट व्हाट इज द पिन पॉइंट्स. ओके और उसको डिस्कस डिसाइड करना पड़ेगा कि 10 लोग हैं, 10 में से मेरे 8 लोग मुझे 10 साल तक चाहिए तो हाउ आई कैन रिटेन देम फॉर 10 इयर्स. व्हाट आर देयर लाइक्स डिसलाइक्स. ओके किसी को फ्लेक्सिबल आवर्स चाहिए, किसी को परफॉर्मेंस पे चाहिए, यू नो हर एक का रिक्वायरमेंट अलग अलग है. अनडिजायरेबल वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस, लॉन्ग आवर, फ्रीक्वेंट बिजनेस ट्रिप, दैट इज ऑल्सो वन रीजन. सैलरीज डू नॉट कंपेयर फेवरेबली विथ इंडस्ट्री पीयर्स. एंड फाइनली लैक ऑफ करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड डेवलपमेंट पाथ. ओके सो करियर एंड डेवलपमेंट इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज अ इंडिविजुअल परसेप्शन. Every employee, if they feel that that employee is not getting opportunities to develop in that organization, the major reason that top management think that they are not getting the career and opportunities. Okay, so this is about the difference view. The psychological contract. Okay, if what the employer provides and employee provides, employer gives the salary, benefit, social contacts, task, training, image, identity, security, values, percent. And against this, what employees gives? Performance, creativity, capability, knowledge, talent, energy, time, health, social network, customer. So this factors, these are the psychological factors. That should be a balanced one. Agar ek bhi balance bigad jata hai, if the salary is not provided proper, the retention, you know, आपका एट्रिशन रेट बढ़ जाएगा, एम्प्लॉय विल लीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. या परफॉर्मेंस, ये दो परसेप्शन है. कोई भी परसेप्शन का कोई भी पॉइंट्स अगर कम ज्यादा हो जाता है, यहाँ पे इक्विलिब्रियम मेंटेन करना जरूरी है. दिस इज द साइकोलॉजिकल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. एम्प्लॉयर कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग, यू नो एम्प्लॉयर प्रोवाइडिंग दिस बेनिफिट टू द एम्प्लॉय एंड एम्प्लॉय यू नो परफॉर्मिंग और गिविंग अगेंस्ट दिस फैक्टर्स टू द एम्प्लॉय. Okay, if the equilibrium not maintained, then automatically your retention strategy plays an important role. Okay, to make maintain this equilibrium. नहीं तो आपका retention strategy fail है. समझ में आई है? Easy understanding में, इतना कुछ difficult slide नहीं है ये. Are you getting guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Great. Yes. So relative job evaluation, ठीक है. So this is certainty of value of alternative job, that is low to high. यहाँ पे difference alternative job compared to current job, that is low to better. If your other job is better, comparative job, यहाँ पे आपका certainty of value of alternative job. So what is that? What is better and high में क्या आता है? Company में जाता है, location आता है, ठीक है. और ये जो circles दिखाई दे रहे हैं आपको, ये relevancy है, high relevancy. तो एवरी वन, ओके कोई भी इंडिविजुअल अगर जॉब छोड़ना चाहता है तो उसका लाइक्स डिसलाइक्स अलग है. जैसे मैंने अभी बताया आपको, पर्सनालिटी मैटर्स, एवरीवन हैव देयर डिफरेंट टेस्ट. किसी को कल्चर चाहिए अच्छा, किसी को बॉस अच्छा चाहिए. बॉस कभी कभी ऐसा देखा नहीं मैंने, आइडियल स्टेट, ठीक है, जहाँ पे बॉस अच्छे होंगे, ठीक है. कभी कभी मिलते भी होंगे बॉस अच्छे. ओके इट्स डिपेंड अपॉन द कल्चर ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. कोई टास्क है, वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस है किसी का इशू, WLB, सैलरी इश्यूज है, सिक्योरिटी इश्यूज है, लोकेशन है, कंपनी इमेज है. सो बट मोस्टली व्हेन यू लीव द जॉब और द करंट एम्प्लॉयर, यू लीव द जॉब फॉर कंपनी इमेज, लोकेशन. ओके दिस बिग सर्कल्स, पीयर्स वन, बॉस वन, यू लीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके सो दिस सर्कल सेज दैट रिलेवेंस इज वेरी हाई फॉर यू. Middle says that relevance is mid, and low says that relevance is very low. Okay, so certainty and difference. ये आपको decide means it helps you to take a decision whether you need to leave the organization or not. तो ये दोनों तरफ से आपको इस graph में बताया गया है कि if you are getting a good opportunity outside, if the difference is better, okay. And certainty is high, then the company image and location plays an important role. Perspective yahan pe hai. Certainty low hai, but difference better hai. So this is the perspective. Task, work-life balance comes in mid of certainty and mid of the difference. And here the certainty is very low, okay, but difference is also low. Peer is very, very less weightage given to us. Boss badhte jayega aise graph, theek hai. So this is said about relative job evaluation, how you are relating your current job with your futuristic job, alternative job, okay, and what type of value that alternative job is giving you as compared to your current job. You compare it na, jab bhi aapko current job chhodna hai to aap kya karoge, aap salary comparison karoge, aap company ka image compare karoge, jo current company hai ya jo aapko offer mila hai us company ka image. Fir aap location dekhoge, location is very important. Agar aapke nearby aapke hometown mein aapko mil raha hai badi company mein offer, to always you will choose a hometown option. Fir security dekhoge, job security kitna hai. One of my friend got a job from CamScore and Wipro. Actually, mera student hai wo, theek hai. Usne mujhe call kiya ki sir, I got a job opportunity from two companies. That is, one is Wipro and another one is CamScore, one of the US best company. Okay. To usne kaha ki kaun si company join karu. To pehle maine usse pucha ki what is your requirement first? You are going for your job security? या यू वॉन्ट अ रिस्क, ठीक है. तो विप्रो में उसको पैकेज मिल रहा था 10 लाख का और CamScore में मिल रहा था 18 लाख का मैनेजमेंट में उसका जॉब था. तो मैंने कहा कि इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर जॉब सिक्योरिटी एंड फॉर अ लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशनशिप, ओके, यू बेटर ज्वाइन विप्रो कंपनी, ओके. बट यहाँ पे तुझे अपॉर्चुनिटी नहीं मिलेगा ज्यादा, ओके, एट आफ्टर 5 or 6 years आप तेरा ग्रोथ स्टॉप हो जाएगा. बट इफ यू आर चूजिंग अ CamScore यूएस बेस्ड फर्म, देर इज अ रिस्क, ओके, बिकॉज द एमएनसीज और द फॉरेनर्स दे बिलीव इन परफॉर्मेंस, ओके. सो फर्स्टली डिसाइड, बट यू आर गेटिंग अ गुड सैलरी, गुड वर्क कल्चर देयर, ओके, एंड एक्सपोजर टू इंटरनेशनल, यू नो, इंटरनेशनल कल्चर, डिफरेंट, यू नो, अप्रोच. तो तेरा उसमें ग्रोथ ज्यादा होगा. So depending upon his requirement, he is ready to take the risk and he joined CamScore. From 6 months, he is working well there. And CamScore provide him work from home till next June, next year June month. Agle saal ke June tak usko work from home flexibility de di unhone. But agar wo Wipro join karta, to aaj usko Pune ja ke join karna padta. So that is a big difference. So why I'm just saying this? Because that is your individual test, how you look towards the job with your current job and how you are going to, you know, select the options. Critical findings. Working for an underperforming boss, 80% said the experience prevented them from learning and hurt their career. And 85% said it made them want to leave the company. War for talent. So basically, bahut baar aise hota hai, cases, if the boss is underperformer, employee is underperformer, that is the another thing, okay. But if your manager is underperformer, then what you think, what you are expecting from him, how he will going to manage you, how will he fulfill your aspiration, okay, your dreams, how will he will help you to, you know, fulfill your dreams. So that is a big problem. Yes Boss movie dekha hai aapne? Yes guys, शाहरुख खान का एंड आदित्य पंचोली का. सनी गाइस आर यू देयर? माय कनेक्शन इज देयर?
यस सर,
यस सर. यस बॉस मूवी देखा है आपने, शाहरुख खान का? यस सर, वो किसी ने तो देखा होगा.
यस सर.
हाँ, तो इसमें उसमें बॉस कैसा है, अंडर परफॉर्मर है क्या, परफॉर्मर बॉस है? यस बॉस मूवी का टाइटल ही है ना, तो ऑलवेज शाहरुख खान इज सेइंग यस बॉस बिकॉज हिज बॉस इज सेइंग दैट ही विल हेल्प हिम इन यू नो फुलफिलिंग हिज ड्रीम, जो उसका ड्रीम है. बट फाइनल लास्ट एंड तक जो बॉस कहता है वो करते रहता है वो, बट लास्ट एंड तक उसको है ना वो ड्रीम नहीं मिलता, फाइनली वो स्टॉप करता है यस बॉस कहना, ठीक है. सो दैट इज अ गुड मूवी, ओके बट फनी थिंग्स मतलब क्या कि अंडर परफॉर्मर जो बॉस है तो मोस्ट ऑफ 80% सेज 85% सेज दैट दे लीव द कंपनी ड्यू टू बैड बॉस नॉट फॉर अ गुड कंपनी. सो मनी में अट्रैक्ट पीपल टू द फ्रंट डोर बट समथिंग एल्स इज नीडेड टू कीप देम फ्रॉम गोइंग आउट द बैक. ओके सो दैट समथिंग इज नथिंग बट अ मिक्सचर ऑफ ऑल द retention things like the compensation, your extrinsic motivation, intrinsic motivation, ye sari cheeze important and that should be in a very proper way. That retention strategy should be there. Have you ever hired the wrong person? So your retention strategy starts from your recruitment and selection only. If you hired a wrong person, then your retention strategy fails at that time only. Reason retention efforts fail, not connected to the vision, mission, and the organizational value. Top leadership not involved, not made part of the organizational strategy, not tied to the bottom line, no clear goals, no one held accountable, delegate to HR to fix. Why the retention strategy or efforts fail? Because it's not linked with your vision and mission. As I said, the retention strategy should start from individual employee. That should be linked with your departmental and that should be linked with your organization. If it is not linked, then it's a complete a failure of your strategy. Top leadership needs to play an important role. It should be a part of organization strategy. And finally, bottom line is also important. Goal is understandable. Every individual, you know, knows about all the policies. If they perform well, what sort of benefit they are getting. Okay, all that kinds of policies clear or the goals clarity is required. And finally, no one is held accountable. Accountability is very important. If some employees are underperforming, okay, or if the group of employees are leaving the organization, you need to just find it out who is accountable for that thing, that incident. Where there is a loophole. Whether there is a loophole in policy or whether there is a loophole in the managerial approach, that you need to think. And finally, delegate it to HR to fix. Always HR department, you know, is a victim. Always whatever thing is happened, finally the HR department is whole and sole responsible. Here, it is not a full-fledged responsibility of HR department, but it is a full-fledged responsibility to organization to retain them. Are you getting it, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Information you must know. Current employee, why do they stay? If you are a manager, you must know about these questions. You must know about why your employees are stay with you. New employee, why did they say yes? Former employees, why did they leave? That you can get this answer from your exit interview. And but interviewed but said no, why? Okay, so these are some questions, okay, that their answer you must know, okay, always about your employee. That the this information you gather from your recruitment selection, that forms, okay, that you are giving at the time of interview, okay, there that behavioral anchored skate bars, one is the interview type, that I have. परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट में हमने एक टेक्निक देखा था बार्स दैट थ्रू बिहेवियर एंकर्ड स्केल मेथड यू आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू फाइंड इट आउट द पर्सनैलिटी एंड द बिहेवियर ऑफ द एम्प्लॉय. ओके एंड सच टाइप ऑफ वेरियस टेक्निक्स आर देयर फ्रॉम वेयर यू गेट द इनसाइट अबाउट द एम्प्लॉयज परसेप्शन. मैनेजर्स रोल्स इन रिटेंशन. मोस्ट मैनेजर्स थिंक्स अबाउट रिटेंशन वेन इट इज अ टू लेट. इनिशियली हमने डिस्कस किया था जब एम्प्लॉय छोड़ के जा रहा है तब आप उसको कन्विंस करना चाहते हैं. आप बोलते हो कि नहीं विल गिव यू द गुड पैकेज और विल व्हाई यू आर लिविंग द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. यही आप अगर कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस में आप लोग रखोगे एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट रखोगे तो ये क्वेश्चन एग्जिट इंटरव्यू का टाइम ही नहीं आएगा. एवरेज मैनेजर डज नॉट टेक पर्सनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर एम्प्लॉय डिपार्चर. मोस्ट फैक्टर्स फॉर टर्न ओवर आर विद इन देयर कंट्रोल. मोस्ट मैनेजर्स डू नॉट रिसीव एडिक्वेट ट्रेनिंग. So these are some role of the managers in the retention strategy. Why good people quit? Poor match between person and the job. Poor fit with the organizational climate and culture. That is a cultural gap. Here there is a career development or personal gap. poor alignment with between pay and performance, poor connection between the individual, their co-workers and the supervisors, poor opportunities for the growth and advancement. So here all these five, words are poor. Poor culture, poor gap in between pay and performance, poor match between person and job, poor connection between communication gap, lack of communication gap in between individual and their co-worker and their supervisor, and the lack of opportunities for growth and advancement. So these are the main reasons why talented people leave your organization. Hire the right people. How do you know what the right person looks like? So you need to scan. The image says that you need to put your employee inside the scanner and just check it out. So this is a funny example, but there are various methods through analytics, through different method, you can just check it out. How do you know what the right person looks like? If you are selected out of 10 employees, 5 employees for your long-term strategy, then you need to just check it out. What is their likes, dislikes with various tools? You can just find it out and you just, provide what they like. Some people like work-life balance. Some people like monetary benefit, compensation benefit. Some people like job security or after retirement plan. Some people like, are different. So everyone's individual test is different. And based on that, you need to fulfill the requirement. And yeah, organization, most of the organizations are not thinking about it. And that's why good people leave the organization. Which practice have the greatest impact on the productivity and shareholders' return? Talent management at the top. That's why you are learning this topic. Attracting the top talent, retention of the top performer, collegial and flexible workplace, rewarding performance and accountability, and finally, the communication. So this is the practice that have the great impact on your productivity. Exit interview, everyone knows what type of, that is an example of Intel. Okay, what was the main reason that you decide to leave? Is your new position in a different line of work than that the one you were in while at Intel? How would you characterize your new employer? Would you say your new employer is better than Intel, about the same as Intel, or not as good as Intel in the terms of? How would you describe your relationship with your manager while you were at Intel? How would you describe your experience with Intel? If a friend approached you and told you was looking for a similar position at Intel, how likely would you recommend Intel? Any other comments about Intel or your new position? So all these questions, 3, 6, 7, 8 questions covers pay, benefit, location, working condition, job security, career opportunities, product quality, co-workers, company leadership, and company image. So these questions gives the answers of these points and why it is required to understand why the employees are leaving the organization. So this answers helps the organization to design a retention strategy, effective retention strategy. And that is linked with all the processes of the HR. That is your recruitment and selection, your training and development, and overall a talent management. Components of retention strategy. If you see target group, you need to target. As I said, you need to group your employees. Those who are those employees you want to retain them for a longer period. Those employees who want to stay with for a shorter time. You need to identify the targeted groups. Underperformer. You need to identify the talented employees. Then problem. Then causes, risk, and measures. What is the relevant internal target group? Your particular units, jobs, countries, key functions, high potentials, and managers, you need to identify the target group. Then what are related turnover costs? If they leave the organization, what is your turnover cost? While designing the retention strategy, you need to answer these questions. Which kinds of costs are generated? Third, why do employee leave the company? What are the internal and external factors and reason for the leaving? So you'll get an insight through that exit interview form. Okay, that tells about why the people are leaving the company. Anticipating turnover and related impact. How big is the likelihood of employees leaving the company and what are related consequences? And here, last question, how can employee be retained? That is an important one. Once you get these answers of this, all these questions, then finally, it is very easy to answer this one. How can employee be retained? Which options are there to effectively retain employees? So you need to go through this target group, then problem identification related to those people, then causes, how it's impacting other, you know, processes, risk related to that turnover, and finally how you are going to measure it. After measuring, you need to, you know, design the strategy. Okay. So this is a tree structure, tree diagram. Okay, where is the problem? Okay, can you just tell me where is the problem here? Employee with strong intention to leave, that is the red circles. An employee without intention to leave, so this blank circle says that employee don't want to leave. But what is the comparative analysis that you saw in between this diagram? Can you just give me a quick answer? Am I audible to all of you? Please tell me first that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What?
Some departments, I think, have too many employees with a strong intention to leave.
Yes. Yeah. So here, if you see here, only one employee wants to leave. So here there is an individual reason that employee is leaving. But here, if you see, there are three employees, employee wants to leave the organization. So here there is not an individual reason. There is some problem in the organization. That's why the people wants to leave, or that department particular. Might be underperformer boss, or some issues in the organizational policies, or might be these three people are not think that this organization suits for their career development. So according to that, you need to set up a retention strategy. You need to find it out. How what is the reason? Okay, at individual level, at group level, and overall at organizational level. So you get this idea. ये जो chart आपको दिख रहा है ना, आने वाले दिनों में आपके dashboard पे दिखेगा ये. If I am a manager, top level management में मैं हूँ, और मुझे देखना है कि current state में कितने लोग, they are intention to leave the organization. Okay, and that is due to the data analytics. Data analytics analyze the data, data कुछ भी हो सकता है. You collect some forms from your all employees. Psychological questions you ask in that form, and you collect the answers, and finally your analytical tools are analyzing that answers and predicting you in the form of chart. These are the employees are intention to leave the organization in upcoming 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. Then I will just check it out amongst this red circle employees, how many of employee are the talented employees, or they want to stay with the organization for a longer period as per the organizational strategy. And accordingly, you need to, you know, design a retention strategy. Okay, so that is the structure, how you're identifying the problem within the organization. Employee retention strategies. Okay, if you see here, so what are the components? Attractive packages, personal training, that training and development are linked here. The compensation benefit process are linked. The recreations, you are just sending them in the development center. You are just upgrading its skill set. Then grievances, you are just trying to resolve the grievances in between the peer ones, your boss and the subordinate, and providing a career development opportunities. So, or bahut sare factors ho sakte hain, but ye majorly, you know, are linked with. Levels of retention strategy, yahan pe aapko clearly bataya jata hai, at individual level, at departmental level, and at organization level. What are the causes, risk, and measures? Will go from bottom level, that is employee level. What are the causes? Performance management, turnover decision styles. Okay. Here, these are the main cause of your retention strategy. Next, what are the risk? Individual risk analysis, performance management, intention to leave. Jaise maine abhi tree structure mein aapko bataya, you need to identify the intention of the people. And what are the measures? New project, new task and colleagues, salary adjustment and more flexibility. Through this retention measures, you can overcome the attrition ratio at the bottom level. Okay, next, at the mid level, managers, management evaluation, causes. What are the risks, current and previous turnover rate? You can just get an insight with a previous last 3 years, how at manager level, okay, the retention attrition ratio is there, and what type of, what sorts of interventions you applied. That is, you can get some major like development, selection, coaching, replacement, objective setting. And at organizational level, causes, employee survey, exit interview, regression analysis. So, yes, can you mute? Mute karoge aap, please.
Sorry.
So, what is at organizational level causes, employee survey, exit interview, regression analysis. From here, you get a detailed analysis, the causes at the organizational level, why the people are leaving. So, what are the risk related that people are leaving, differentiated turnover rate. Okay. And it's impacting all the organization process and what type of measures that you can take to, you know, what type of retention strategy that improving employer attractiveness to internal talent market, flexible working hours. So this organization level, okay, main aapko short mein bataunga, that is effective talent management strategy. Effective talent management strategy should link with your retention strategy, because retention strategy part hai talent management ka. Okay. That is a part of your talent management. When I'm saying that effective talent management strategy, then indirectly I'm saying that effective retention strategy. So at this three level, how you can find the cause, how you can identify the risk, and in third measures that how you can mitigate the risk. These are the levels of retention strategy at three levels. So finally, the conclusion is, employee retention is crucial for the long-term health and success of the business. Managers readily agree that retaining best employees ensures customer satisfaction, product sales, satisfied co-workers, goodwill of the organization, etc. So in short, if you truly respect, appreciate, and treat your employees wonderfully, you will never lose them. So guys, here there is an end of your talent management, talent acquisition, talent management part, and end of your syllabus. That is talent acquisition and management. Yes. Is there any question for now?
No, sir. Next lecture, we will be having a session, so we can discuss about any queries with regards to the important questions, no?
Yeah. Next week might be there will be a session or not. Okay, I will tell you 2 or 3 days before, and that is from my side. Okay, if you want to schedule the session, then we'll meet. Okay, of course, on Sunday, next Sunday. Okay, aur ek cheez aapse puchni thi, whether you are interested to appear for what subjective exam. 1 hour का एक सब्जेक्टिव एग्जाम 10 मार्क का रखें नेक्स्ट वीक में.
So subjective as in MCQ?
4 questions. No. Subjective is nothing but I will ask some questions. Okay, 4 questions are there and you need to type it. That's it. आपको टाइप करना है वहाँ पे. That is in 50 words or 100 words. Your perceptions.
So we can discuss it, but I think that would be ideal.
Okay, fine. So you just let me know. Next week we am will meet depending upon your choice. Okay. So now today the end of the syllabus. Okay, is there any question? 20 din hai hamare paas. You study that 40 questions. Okay. Koi bhi agar aapko doubt aata hai, to anytime you can just approach to me. Okay, and ask me. Okay. Yes, Sunny, Francia, Alicia, Dipali, final comment from you. Because today our syllabus end.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So we'll stop here now.
Yes, sir, fine.
Yeah. Thank you all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.